So I'm Shrishti Sagar, the class speakathon coordinator of MBA Finance. There are some guidelines. Your camera should be on. Arun, please keep your camera on. Arun, please turn on your camera.
Shrishti, Arun has voice problem. So,
okay.
I think he did not hear your voice.
Okay, I'll just write it in the chat box. Okay. Okay, so we should start now. Sushma, can you please just turn on your camera? Just a minute, we are starting in a minute. Okay. Good evening. I am Shrishti Sagar, the class speakathon coordinator for MBA Finance. And the group discussion topic that we are going to talk about today is preferably the most hyped topic currently, that is the cryptocurrency. And I would like to know, before starting, let's just get a general view of what is cryptocurrency and why it is so much hype. It is basically a collection of binary data, binary data which is based in a database. So that is that. And through blockchain, I think it is helpful for us. It is helpful for us to decentralize. So I would just like to know your views of what you think about crypto, because I think due to crypto, the layers, like if I want to if I want to transfer money from say India to Bangladesh, so there comes so many regulations, so many government regulations. Due to cryptocurrency, due to Bitcoin, the regulations, the layers of the government, that is basically not there because of that, and we there's no middleman that is required, so that is a good way, I think. So what do you think? We can start with
maybe you were right, but I guess there is no, what can say, illegal trend is there in cryptocurrency. There is no governing authority over there. So I guess it's illegal and it's not safe, actually.
Okay. Anyone want to add up something, Muskan?
Yes, I am agree with Naman, because cryptocurrency has no central monetary authority, or if we send, it's a virtual currency. If we send it, it cannot retrieve. If we send by chance, by a mistake to anyone, then we cannot retrieve our virtual currency, or we can forget our virtual coin number or anything, that nobody is here who can retrieve back it.
Yes, of course. But don't you think there's so much of money that is invested, that is stored in cryptocurrency? People are literally spending so much money on crypto. So if government bans it, what about the current, like what about all that money that is into the picture? Like, where does it go? Like, what happens? You understand like what I'm trying to say? Okay, yeah. Asking.
Basically, cryptocurrency is something which anyone can simply put the servers on and start mining the currency. There is no actual money in there at initial stages, apart from you're investing in servers or internet or electricity or something else. Basically, you are just mining and making people pay for you for that. There is a recent case of that Squid Coins, which recently boomed by 10,000%, and next day it was just zero.
Yeah, exactly. Manisha, can you turn on your camera? But I think, like you said, that it's not safe, right? But like, it's like today, like in 2018, we went through recession, of course. We went through financial crisis. That also happened because of some failures of banks. So it's like we can't trust a entity. That is why people are more dependent and getting attracted towards crypto. So what do you think about it? Like,
yes, Rishti, mostly people can attract you to it, but it has many risks. I mean, high level risk it contains. So cryptocurrency has no its own value. It's just depend on demand. If its demand increases, value of cryptocurrency is also increases. But if demand decreases, the value of cryptocurrency then decreases, which can be a great risk, high risk. It can be a, you are means spend all your money that you have all lost, or you get a high profit.
Yes, yes, of course. Like Komal, Renu, will you add something to this? What are your views on crypto?
एडवांटेज होते हैं बस इसके, बट इसके कुछ एडवांटेजेस भी होते हैं, जैसे ये डिसेंट्रलाइज है, कोई एक कंट्री किसी एक गवर्नमेंट का अलग अलग पावर्स इसके कंट्रोल नहीं कर सकती हैं, ये सबके थ्रू कंट्रोल होता है, इसलिए सबको इसका राइट होता है। और बिटकॉइन लिमिटेड होती है ना, इसके 21 मिलियन इसको मतलब इतने ही प्रोड्यूस कर पाते हैं, इसके आगे नंबर नहीं जाएगा इसका। ऐसा नहीं है कि बिटकॉइन ओवर प्रोड्यूस कर दिए जाए और इकोनॉमी,
दैट्स अ वेरी वेरी गुड पॉइंट दैट इट कांट बी प्रोड्यूस्ड, सो इट्स इट वुड देयर वुड बी सम सॉर्ट ऑफ सिक्योरिटी दैट इट हैज इट्स प्रोस एंड कॉन्स, यू सी, लाइक नथिंग इज हियर राइट और रॉन्ग, लाइक यू आर जस्ट डिस्क्राइबिंग योर ओपिनियंस।
बट सृष्टि, इट्स आल्सो हैव अ डिसएडवांटेज ऑफ डिसेंट्रलाइज्ड अथॉरिटी। बाय चांस इफ यू लॉस्ट योर कॉइन, तो नोबडी कैन रिट्रीव देम। Who is responsible for that?
Yeah. Exactly. A Bitcoin worth rupees almost 40 lakh or 44 lakh now. And if a hacker will come into your account, or if a hacker hacked your account, you lost your Bitcoin, you lost your coins, and you can imagine the money you're going to lose, because it is not a physical form. In like a paper money, we have a 500 or 1000 rupee, 2000 rupee note. But in cryptocurrency, you don't have any kind of note, any kind of currency in hand. It doesn't mean in a physical form, and typically which is not issued by a central authority too. If you lost something, then you lost it all at all, because we can also like say with an example that in many cases of Supreme Court or High Court in India only, hackers try to build their hack in the cryptocurrency account, and they try to build their network through cryptocurrency, and many person like at last lost their money in crypto.
Yes,
I agree with us, because we know in 2014 there is a judge in Japan which is an online hacking case, and in this near about $460 million can be theft by stealing the users and passwords of 60,000 people.
Yes, yes. Tesla also I think invested $1.45 billion just to hold the crypto currency. Like, it happened, like some news.
I think they have a control on crypto, huh, na? If Elon Musk asks, Bitcoin will,
you know,
rise, anything will rise, no?
Yeah.
If they can build their own currency on crypto, it can boom in within seconds, I think.
Right.
And I think Bitcoin and Ether are the only well-known cryptocurrencies, if I'm not wrong. And I researched on these currencies as well, and I came out with an idea like there are Ripple, Goma, Icon, Helium, a lot of cryptocurrencies which is just newly added on the Bitcoin's apps and Bitcoin. Every day there is some kind of a currency, which even a currency named Shinu IMA like something, and that just have a value of 0.001, like a 1 paisa, less than 1 paisa also. Like there are cryptocurrencies like this also.
Yeah.
And people think we can invest a lot in that, but you can lose it all at all. If
of course,
that will not go into boom.
Risk factor here. Yeah, one Bitcoin is, I think, worth today 35 to 36 lakhs, and that is a huge number. Like,
it sometimes goes to 40, 44 lakh every day. It comes down to 30, then 35. Yeah.
Basically, it's a store of value. Everything is going digital. And that is how it is. Like in medieval times, we used to invest in gold because that was a store of value. So that is how it is. Bitcoin is also, it is a modern digital way of store of value, I think. So yeah, but definitely it has its pros and cons. So we'll get to Komal. Can you just on your microphone and tell us your views about any like advantages, disadvantages, what do you feel about crypto? Anything.
उसमें रिस्क इतना भी ज्यादा नहीं है क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट ने ना स्टेप्स लिए हैं इसके रिस्क को लेके कि पीयर टू पीयर डील्स होंगी मतलब ब्लॉकचेन्स के अकॉर्डिंग तो कोई भी और मतलब इंसान आपकी उनको देख नहीं सकता जो भी ट्रांजैक्शन हुई है या कोई भी इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं ले सकता ये हो गया और टैक्स ऑन एयर ड्रॉप्स कॉइन मतलब गवर्नमेंट ने अभी टैक्स भी लगाया है एयर ड्रॉप्स कॉइन्स पर लेटेस्ट न्यूज है ये और कैपिटल क्राइटेरिया भी है फॉर एक्सचेंज आई थिंक इतना भी ज्यादा रिस्क नहीं है क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट ने इसके अकॉर्डिंग स्टेप्स उठाए हैं और आरबीआई जो भी रिस्क इसमें इन्वॉल्व है आई थिंक आरबीआई उसके लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबल होगा
यस यस कैन वी हियर समथिंग फ्रॉम मनीषा शी कांट टर्न ऑन हर कैमरा ओके रेनू व्हाट डू यू थिंक
नहीं है इसमें बहुत ज्यादा पावर यूज होती है मोर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यूज होती है सो इट इज नॉट इको फ्रेंडली
I feel it is a good way, like blockchain is a good way to decentralize. What are your views on blockchain? Any one of you?
And Srishti, near about 2.9 million to 5.8 million are active users of cryptocurrency in a world. And mostly countries like US, Canada, Australia, Japan, they are all use cryptocurrency, but some countries are who can ban cryptocurrency also.
Yeah. India is also coming into the picture. US and all, they started. So, okay. So, anyone wants to add something to it?
I think so. Blockchain is something now, a record of every transaction. If you are doing some online transaction of crypto, then they have a record in kind of a blockchain, in kind of a secure network.
Public, like you can publicly see the transaction. The fact that the transaction happened, you know, that would be the ledger, would be public. So,
yeah, that ledger posting in public. Also,
right? Yeah. So the transparency is there and the public faith should be there, I feel.
And blockchain, it means every transaction is to be stored as a block. And then we can collect the blocks in like the chain. So it can solve to be a blockchain technology. Yes. And as a at public, see all the transactions and all the things.
now everyone is very curious to know about crypto and blockchain technology because everything is going digital. Now everyone is trying to understand it, and the massive number that is there. So I think that is the reason.
And I think it all started with Bitcoin only. I think in 2008 or 9 maybe, in 2009, Bitcoin was the first online software which was like released as a decentralized crypto. And it's all start from there, the concept of blockchain. Then the Ether might come, huh, nah? Ether as a crypto come. And from there only the blockchain concept, the crypto concept come in the picture. And now we can see a lot of cryptocurrencies are there.
Yes, totally.
Yes, in 2009, Bitcoin is the first currency, but in India, it can be on 2020. But in 2018, RBI can ban it, and then it can be in 2020, some in India.
Yeah, exactly.
So, yes, I personally feel that it is good, and everyone should invest some amount of money in Bitcoin because the number is huge. There's a massive number. So I think everyone should at least invest some of the money for Bitcoin.
We talk about facts and figures of cryptocurrency. The Bitcoin has hit more than 50% down in last month. If we check the facts and figures, the Bitcoin hit from 45 lakhs to 25 lakhs in no time.
Yeah.
You can just have a sleep of 7 or 8 hours and then you can see a boom or bang in cryptocurrency.
Yeah, the risk factor will always be there. But it's also about the trust. Nah? Like if we trust the banks, like we did it, like in 2008 also, like the financial crisis, it happened because of that. So the people don't want a middleman to trust. So crypto just cuts that thing, like the Bitcoin thing, I feel personally. The layers of regulations, I think, is reduced, and it's just directly you can, you know, transfer the value.
Like you said that we can't trust the bank with our money. Basically, we don't trust bank actually on the money. We trust the RBI that is ruling all the banks. We look at another case. We can say we buy a shares of any companies. We don't buy shares because they are just paper. Shares are just papers. But we know that if we buy the share, we become the partner of the company. At least we have something in hand. But when we buy cryptocurrency or something, there is nothing to back them.
Yes. Earlier there was gold, but yes, now, yeah.
In India also, whenever India buy gold, let's say India buy worth 1 lakh rupees of gold, then India will print 1 lakh rupees of coin. That's why the fiat currency is backed by gold only in India also.
And you know that I think due to that, the fiat currency is also declining.
This is declining, but it's also backed by gold actually. As many as India will buy gold from foreign or it will mine in India also, it will print that much of money actually.
Yeah, so we have diverse, diverse thinking here. Anyone wants to add anything to it? Manisha, we can't.
Okay, so I think it's conclusion. If we control the risk and we can pay money or in Bitcoin or with the knowledge, don't... do your shares or take the shares without any knowledge and just that and yes, it's okay, that buy it. With knowledge, if you can buy and you can when money is low, you can buy it and then you can sell it, or with a proper knowledge, when you are in a deep knowledge, you that money and or a profit.
Yeah, so the basically I think the conclusion here would be that it is useful. Definitely, I think one should invest in crypto, but I think it also has risk. Risk is everywhere. I think you have to take risk. That is the foremost important.
Yeah,
and invest in crypto when with a deep knowledge.
Yes, yes, definitely. You need a strong knowledge about crypto to understand the market, then invest.
If we are trading stock market, now we have a like we have a term called stop loss. I think you heard about it, Christy and Muskan, right? We had a term called stop loss and target. But in cryptocurrency, there is nothing like it. Like if you buy a Bitcoin worth rupees 30 lakh and in night only it goes beyond like 20 or 10 or 0, you can have nothing in hand. Because there is no concept of like stop loss or a target. If you have a concept of stop loss in crypto only, your loss will be just with the extent. Like you lost only 5 lakh or 10 lakh or 5,000, 10,000 as per your risk of, capacity. If I trade in stock market, I always use stop loss and target. But in cryptocurrency, there is no term like this. And I think that is most explosive. I think that is more risky, which made cryptocurrency.
Yes. Yeah. Nisha, can we hear something from your side?
I have no knowledge about cryptocurrency, so I listen to you all.
Okay, so what do you guys think, like one should invest in crypto? Because you know, there's a lot of risk and the money, and then government is also thinking about banning it. There is a lot of risk, of course, definitely. So do you feel that it's worth it?
I think we should wait for the next statement of government. like a week ago only, I think our Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi ji said some fishy words. I heard about I heard his speech, but I don't think like he's not banning it, but he's not approving it at all. Also, that was in middle of something.
Earlier, I think
they're not approving it.
Yeah, they are definitely not approving it. Because...
And they're not also right now. If we go more risky, it can be. And if we invest low, it can be our loss too. So we are in the middle of the ocean where our government is not banning the cryptocurrency and not approving it at all also.
Yes, yes. I totally agree. So the conclusion here, I feel that one should invest in it, but definitely one should understand the market. One should understand the fundamentals and everything about crypto, and should have knowledge about the current affairs that is going on, so that they could invest in a better way. So I think that is all. We should
yes, Rishti.
Group discussion. Thank you so much to everyone who joined. Thank you for your valuable time. And it was really nice talking to you. We will definitely have a next group discussion in week 2. Thank you everyone for joining. And
thank you.
Thank you. And just
thank you.
Thank you everyone.